Imagine you're swimming at the lake on a hot summer day, and your friend says, "Hey, I bet you can't touch the bottom." And you're like, "I bet you I can." So you take a deep breath, and you swim down and down and down, and suddenly it gets cold, and you stop. What is this? What's going on? You've just experienced something that's hugely important to everything that goes on in the lake. It's called thermal stratification. After you get back to the surface and catch your breath, you think, why is it warm up here but cold below? Is it always this way? Let's run an experiment and find out. What we have here is a model of a lake cut in half down the middle. We've taken all the warm water, dyed red, and moved it to one side. The cold water, dyed blue, is moved to the other side. In the middle is this barrier that keeps the sides separate. Now let's remove the barrier and watch what happens. As you can see, there's a lot of movement between the two layers as they come together. But look, the warm water has settled out on top. Let's try the experiment again. This time we put the cold water on the left and the warm water on the right, just to see if it makes a difference. Once again, the warm water settles out on top. What's going on? To answer that, we need to take a look at the physical principle driving the whole show, density. Density is the amount of stuff in a given volume. In our case, that stuff is water, and that volume is this glass beaker. This beaker is filled to the brim with our cold water. Let's see how much it weighs. grams. Now we've emptied the cold water and refilled the beaker with the warm water. And the warm water weighs in at 165.1 grams, a little bit less than the cold water. We can calculate the density of these two samples by dividing the mass by the volume. First, we need to correct our previous measurement by subtracting out the mass of the empty beaker. This gives us 116.2 grams for the cold water and 115.1 grams for the warm water. Now we divide by the volume of the beaker to get a cold water density of 1.00 grams per milliliter and a warm water density of 0.99 grams per milliliter. In reality, it's a very small difference, but that small difference has a big impact. It allows the warm water to essentially float on top of the cold water, and it keeps the two layers from mixing together. So what affects the temperature, and in turn, the density of the water in the lake? You might think the temperature of the air surrounding the lake is the answer, but really, the biggest impact comes from the sun. As sunlight enters a lake, it warms the surface water, making it less dense and lighter. As the surface water begins to float on the cold water below, a transition zone forms where it changes from warm to cold very quickly. We call that the thermocline. Remember, thermal stratification in lakes is as ordinary as the changing of the seasons, and in fact, it does change with the seasons. But we'll save that for another time. For now, know that warm water, cold water, and a thing called density set the stage for the behavior of, well, really everything that goes on in a lake. It's very important.